Hi guys, and welcome to the explanation on the Gantt chart. So the Gantt chart is a template that is used to track project activities. And it's great to get a first and quick view at how you're doing in terms of the duration of each project activity. What I want to do in this video is walk you through the individual customization steps to make sure that this template can be used for projects in your business. So essentially, we're going to be looking at the individual steps you need to perform to make sure that this is really suited to your business. Now let's first look at the Gantt chart as such. So you see right here that you can change the project name first. So this is, you know, project Y. You see that this is directly translated into the chart title over here. If we quickly look at the individual steps, we first need to change the activity names. Now, of course, this template comes with pre-populated data. These are just dummy activities that you can freely change. You can also delete them if you want by just removing the rows if you wanted to. And at the same time, if you wanted to add one of these activities, you just type in activity 11. You can populate the planned starting date, the planned duration. Now, these formulas will update automatically. Edit the actual starting date and the actual duration. So, you know, sometimes the actuals don't come in quite as planned. And what you can also track is the completion over here. And then these will then translate directly into the completed days and the delta. But let's go step by step. I'm just gonna go ahead, quickly remove this row, and we go back to the introduction. So now that we have assigned names to the individual activities, and you know, we could maybe have added some of them. Now we need to go ahead and populate the cells C and D for the planned dates. Yeah. So we go ahead, enter these numbers, say activity one starts on the 4th of June, and it takes about 5 days to complete this one. Now this number here will of course change because what I put in here is a formula. It says today minus 12. So that's today's date minus 12 dates. If applicable, there are certain holidays that fall into the duration period of the entire project. Yeah, so those could be individual bank holidays that you may have in your country or say in your city even. So you can go ahead and enter them over here in this green area, and they will then be excluded from the calculation of workdays. So everything in gray is calculated automatically. No need for you to take any action here. However, if you've edited the holidays over here, they will of course be excluded from the planned end date. So once we've done this, we have one crucial step that we need to make. And let's quickly read the formula over here, the text. So in order to make sure that our x-axis within the chart is displayed properly, we need to change the minimum bounds to a specific serial number. And this specific serial number, now in this case, as of today, is 43,976. This number will change depending on when you open up the template, because if you look at the formula bar up here, it refers to a cell. It looks at the Gantt chart in C8 and deducts 10 days. So let's look at the cell C8 quickly. C8 is essentially the first starting date of your planned activity. So the x-axis, which is this piece over here that goes horizontally, needs to be changed to make sure that we get this right value in. Because otherwise, the problem will be that your axis is not going to update correctly and that some of the bars will not be visible. So let's quickly refresh our memory. So today, I'm using it today, I need to enter 43,976 as the minimum bound. So the way I do this is I just select the x-axis. You see that I get this little rectangle around it. And then I just press Control 1. This opens up the minimum bounds. Yeah, and then I can enter a specific number in here. So let's just change this to 76. And you see that automatically my chart here is changing. This is the first crucial step you need to make. Once you've done this, you can just close it again. Yeah? And now This now sets the right boundaries for your chart display. And now whatever project activities you have in here, the upper bounds will be adjusted automatically. Okay, now this was the most important and most difficult part of this template. Everything else after that is super easy. Now I've also put a little screenshot down here just for you to keep track of these. Yeah, so we select the x-axis, we press Control 1, and then we change this number over here. Now in the last step, we just need to adjust for the percentage completion of each activity. Now let's look at what this means. Let's say that the first activity is completed 100%, then you see that this dark green bar actually fulfills the activity completely. But if I change this to just 50%, you see that actually moves back. So it's like a fulfillment tracker, so to speak. Yeah, anything you put in here in the completion bar will fill the stacked bar chart to a certain extent. Then of course this will always adjust automatically. Now overall you may want to track how you're performing in terms of saved or wasted days, and what I mean by that is, you know, sometimes the actual duration is lower than the planned duration, and this we're tracking in the delta column K. In this particular case it's saying -4 days, so that means that we've actually completed the activity 4 days ahead of start or ahead of plan. It's a simple formula, just deducting actual duration minus the planned duration, but it also gives you the visualization right here in this column. So I hope that you'll be using the Gantt chart, because it's a super powerful tool to track the performance of individual activities and to make sure that you're still on track.